a little bigger. Just a little bit bigger than usual. Uploading it like three times, no dice. So I ended up re-uploading the original onto the computer. Then it worked, but the weird thing was the whole time you could watch it like on my editing program, it was all there. It didn't freeze up or anything. It was only when you put it on YouTube. I don't know. They were having a little glitch. Hear that little click? Those little yellow things they put in the middle after they pave it. Little flappers. The trailer tires hit them. Inspector for a couple of the towns around me. I'm pretty sure at least two of them. And he has a plumbing company, so you know what that means. Lots of scrap. talk to them on the old Facebook. Once in a while, he has me come pick stuff up. Nothing great, you know. But decent little things anyway. But anyway, he, anyway. Sends me a message, says, you know, how much do you pay for vehicles? And I said, depends what it is. He said, well, 94 F-150. I said, well, I gave him a price. I said, this is what I pay for a complete vehicle. And he said, Chris, I don't think it has cats on it. And I said, well, probably not, because lately, every goddamn car that I look at or pick up doesn't have cats on it. Real bad thing up here right now. A lot of thefts. Pretty soon, probably won't even be able to sell them. Probably need some special license. So he said, I don't think it has cats. And I said, well, normally, I mean, I didn't say this to him, but normally what I tell people is I don't even want to buy a vehicle that doesn't have cats. And actually, I don't even want to junk it because it's a long haul for me to make very little profit on just the scrap, you know, just the body of the vehicle itself. It's not worth it. So, because it was him, you know, I said, I'll make very little profit in order to make this guy happy, because in the long run, he's gonna, you know what I'm saying anyway. There's gonna be more good things to come out of it. So, I said, I'd pay. For that anyway, you know, give him something for it anyway, just, you know, to make him happy and pick it up and whatever, everyone, you know. So he said, well, you know, it's got, and now you get everyone up here, it's got brand new tires on it, it's got a brand new battery in it. Well, brand new means like tires from like 1995 and like, you know, battery that's like 3 years old, been sitting in the winter, doesn't work. Usually that's how it goes. But anyway, I said, you know, send me a picture of these tires. Let me see this thing. So they have pretty nice tires on it. And I said, all right, so I offered him a little more, enough where I could still not lose money, and turn around, maybe sell the tires, make a little profit. So he said, okay, it's all yours. It's at this shop, and the guy, you know, it's a kid that worked for him as a plumber. The truck died. I used to see the truck driving around all the time, very recently. He said, guy thinks the computer died in it, so it don't run. So big rock just hit the trailer. So he said, it's gotta get out of there, go get it, get it out of there, go pick it up for me. Okay. So I went over there next day and met me, gave him the money, and I thought nothing of it. And he said, you know, he said, I would have gave it to you, but, you know, the kid bought a car off of me, and blah, 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 I needed to regain some money, and he beat me up on the price, whatever. Big story, all done. So I winch it on the trailer, and it's not till gone, and I'm hooking up the rear chain on the rear end, and I look, I see two parts are still there. What are you going to do? So, good thing for me. Good news. So I get it back home, and sure enough, it wasn't all good news. The front cap was totally burnt out, which usually happens on the Fords. And the rear one, a little broken up inside, a little shaky, but seems to be pretty full. So there's the profit, so I'm not really too worried. So I cut those off of there. And I've been talking to this guy that online a bit, that's a fellow scrapper. He's up further north, almost near the Canadian border, a couple hours. Actually, about an hour and a half, 2 hours for me is pretty much the Canadian border. So he's up there. He likes my trucks, but he's also, he runs these old body style Fords. He likes them. He's got a diesel, he's got a fuel, a few gas ones. So I've been talking to him a little bit lately, and I figured, you know, since I'm seeing his pictures and Fords and this and that, I'm like, well, you know, we sent pictures back and forth, and I sent him a picture, and he goes, man, that's gorgeous, I love it. I said, really? You like this thing? Yeah. I want that thing. I said, well, let's go to the crusher, you know. What you give me? Well, he said, I really want it. I want the tires. I want the truck. I have a computer for it. I want to fix it, or maybe, you know, use it for parts, whatever. I said, well, you want it, make me an offer. I can't refuse. And so that he did. No cats. You know, said, I don't care. Okay. So. Oh, and the battery that was in it was like 2 years old. It's junk. But anyway. So he said, yeah. I said, where do you want to meet? He said, let's meet halfway. So about an hour for me through a nice little back road here. North. It's a 2 hour ride. This truck. Bring it down south, scrap it, so, and I'm getting paid more, plus I still got that cat off of it to cash in later, so I figured it's a pretty good situation. He's all excited about getting the truck, and assuming he's meeting me at the gas station, the empty trailer, pay me in cash, take it away. Go about my day and move on to the next one. I like it when things work out like that, you know. Lately it's, you know, you always got the broken dreams, but you know, something you get and you're like, you know, it's like I'm heading to pick it up and I'm not really excited about it because it's not really a huge money maker. It's a big stupid Ford truck. No cats, no money, no nothing. You know, I gotta take tires off. I gotta, you know, paint the wheels to sell them. That time. talk to you was about 15 minutes. Ice is all melted. No ice left.